Hello everyone, good evening. I'm Prasoon Agrawal from EQ International Magazine, and today I have the pleasure to be here with Mr. Yeshwant Rao, who is the co-founder and managing director at Oriano Solar. Oriano Solar is one of the leading EPC providers, service providers in the solar industry right now. So hello Yeshwant sir.
Yeah, hi.
First of all, sir, I would just like to begin with a brief introduction about Oriano Solar and what services is it offering in the Indian market right now.
Yeah, so Oriano Solar is a turnkey EPC company. We offer right from design, engineering, procurement, construction of the entire plant, including transmission line for our clients. We have been in this business since year 2015. We've executed more than 100 megawatts of solar power plant as of now. Recently we commissioned a 50 megawatt power plant for a American company called First Solar using thin film technology modules and 1500 volt technology for modules as well as inverters.
Sir, what sort of market opportunities right now do you see in the Indian solar market right now? And as a general question, I would like to know, out of the 100 gigawatt target, how much market share do you expect to capture?
Yeah, so as 100 gigawatt is for 2022. Our guess is in the year 2018, there could be a market size of about somewhere around 15 to 20 gigawatt. So we are also looking at different models like for private PPA potential customers, EPC for them, as well as the companies who are executing say SECI projects or government projects. We are targeting that segment as well as the rooftop customers who are the consumers by themselves. Just to give you example, we recently executed some projects in North India, in Noida, currently executing a rooftop project for one of the leading automobile company in Maharashtra. This financial year we also executed around more than 5 megawatts for another leading automobile conglomerate from India.
Yeshwant sir, I would like to have your comments on any recent noteworthy project which your company must have installed, and what were the learning outcomes out of that particular project, if you can throw some light on that.
Yeah, so as I said, we just completed a 50 megawatt solar power plant for First Solar, and it's one of the unique projects in India, being probably one of the very few 1500 volt projects in India. The modules are from First Solar and the inverters are from GE. The cables and lot of other material that has gone into it, including the transformers and other parts, are made specially suitable for this 1500 volt technology. And it was a very interesting project. One of the sites in Karnataka, both the sites, it's 25 megawatt into two projects, and both of the sites are in Karnataka state. One of the site had a black cotton soil, so we had to design the piling foundation specifically for that application, and we encountered certain challenges during the execution, being the black cotton soil, and it was a kind of rainy season, so movement of the workers and movement of material was a challenge. But our team on the site, they really worked very hard day and night, and we commissioned the project in a very short period of time.
So looking at the trend of project developers bidding for solar projects in the country, they have been bidding record low prices for each and every upcoming new project. So what sort of cost pressures does it bring upon on a EPC company like yours?
Yeah, so see, it's a spiraling effect. Basically, you know, from if the developers are bidding a competitive price, obviously, to meet their returns demands, they would expect a competitive price from an EPC company like ours, and it will go down to the level of you know, the equipment manufacturers. When we have to offer a competitive price, the equipments like the modules or the inverters, transformers, these prices will have to become more and more you know, competitive to withstand this. But one of the scenario that is happening off late is, as you know, pre-GST period, whatever excise was applicable on equipments with MNRE certification, the cost was nil for a developer. But now that facility is not available and GST is applicable. So also for imports of the modules, some of the ports have started imposing the, you know, imports duty on that to the extent of about 7.5%, and the GST is becoming applicable. So these two factors are having an impact in the cost of the EPC and increasing the cost for developer. So probably because of these, some of the factors like this, there could be a situation where the prices may not go down lower to what we had heard last. They may go up a little bit.
Just one last question on the general business environment for the solar market in the country. You know, with the uncertainty regarding anti-dumping duties, recent news coming up regarding the renegotiation of PPA. So, what's your view on that? How's the general business environment for the players?
Yeah, so see, because of the some uncertainty whether the anti-dumping duty will be become applicable or not, there is little impact on the decision making by the consumers. They're saying that they would want to wait for some time and see, you know, what is the decision by the ministries and the government with respect to that, and based on that they would ultimately decide when they want to, you know, start the project.
Alright sir, that was a really nice opportunity speaking with you here. Thank you so much for your time.
Yeah, thank you so much. Nice meeting.